Hello, hi, good evening. Welcome to Azotech channel. I'm Dr. Sangeeta. I've come here to present the topic on history of classification. So in my previous video, I might have told the diversity in the living world, in which I was talking about the taxonomy and systematics. Today, we'll deal with the history of classification. So, this early classification of organisms were based on only two criteria, that is beneficial, other one will be the harmful animals. So, an ancient classification system recognized five animal groups, that is domestic, wild, creeping, flying and sea animals. So, initially the classification was based on organisms' fundamental characteristics such as the habitat and the morphology only. So this, as I already told you, Aristotle, who was the father of taxonomy, Aristotle, that is 384 to 322 BC. So this Aristotle was the first to classify all the animals in his history of animals called Historia Animalium. It's called as Historia Animalium. Historia Animalium, that is, you call it as in Latin. So he attempted a basic classification of all the living organisms into plants and animals. So these animals were classified based on locomotion. So that is walking, the terrestrial mode. Flying, that is aerial. Swimming will be the aquatic. So, based on the presence or absence of the red blood cells, he named it as anaema. Anaema, that is the presence of RBCs, the red blood cells, and the absence you call as anema. Anaema, and we call it as anaema, A-N-I-M-E. So we classify the animals into two as anaema, the other one with the anaema, anema and anaema. So this Aristotle's classification system had only limitations, and many of the organisms were not fitted into his classification. You can say, for example, is the tadpoles or frogs, they're born in water and they have gills when they are metamorphosed into the adult frogs. They have lungs and they can live both in water as well as on the land. They are terrestrial animals. So how can you classify the frogs and where to place them? So this Aristotle, what he did, he classified organisms based on locomotion. Hence, birds, bats and flying insects, they were grouped together just by absorbing one single characteristic feature, that is the flying ability. Can you understand? So the birds can fly, the bats can fly, and the insects, the flying insects. So they are all coming under the flying category. On the contrary to the above set example, if you take ostrich, emu and a penguin, they are all birds but they cannot fly. Is it not? So Aristotle would not classify them as birds. So in spite of these limitations, the Aristotle classification was followed for more than 2000 years up to 1700. Till 1700, we were following only the Aristotle system of classification. After Aristotle, his student, Theophrastus, that is, he lived in 327 to 287 BC, and he continued his research on the classification of plants, and he was known as the father of botany. So there was a huge gap till 16th century, and then the English naturalist who was called John Ray, yeah, he lived in the he was in the period of 1627 to 1705. He wrote several important books in his lifetime. So his important contribution was the establishment of species as the ultimate unit of taxonomy. So he published a book called Methodus Planetarum Nova. So which contained about 18,000 plant species as a relatively narrow species concept. So this what happened? Then afterwards a modification system is a numerical taxonomy which evolved in the year 1950s. So this system, what happened, they evaluated the resemblances, that is what are the similarities and dissimilarities, differences, to the statistical methods, followed by computer analysis to establish the numerical degree of relationship between the among the individuals. So then it finally emerged to a classification called cladistics. So what is cladistics? That is, it is an evolutionary, that is a classification based on how a common ancestry was shared. So this cladistic classification, it summarizes the genetic differences between all the species in the phylogenetic tree. So the system of classification taking into account, that is, ancestral character, that is the traits or the basic body design, which would be the entire group, and derived character, the traits. We call it as panbugal, not the traits in Tamil. So the panbugal, we call it in Tamil, the traits whose structure and function differ from those of the ancestral characters. So that is a cladogram. And so depending on the system of classification, the organisms, they were classified into two or three kingdoms. Later it became 4 or 5, 6, and now finally it has come to 7 kingdoms. So so many scientists, they have formulated the kingdom classification. Say for example, R.H. Whittaker. So R.H. Whittaker, in the year 1969, he proposed the 5 kingdom classification. That is, the kingdom defined by him were, what are the kingdom defined by him? Monera, then Protista, then Fungi, Monera, Protista, Fungi, then Plantae, Animalia. So this is the 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is the 5 kingdom system by Whittaker. So based on cell structure, mode of nutrition, mode of reproduction, as well as by the phylogenetic relationship. And then these are the 5 kingdom given by R.H. Whittaker. Now we'll talk about the 3 domains of life. So the 3 domains of life, this was proposed by the 3 domains. What are the 3 domains of life? Was proposed by Carol Woese. Was proposed by Carol Woese in the year 1977. So he classified organisms based on the difference in the 16S rRNA, that is the ribosomal RNA genes. So this system emphasizes the separation of the prokaryotes into 2 domains. That is, you call it as prokaryotes, they do not have the nucleus, right? So that is, you'll be having the 2 domains. One will be the bacteria, the other one you call it as archaea. And all the eukaryotes, they are placed in the domain called eukarya. Eukarya means they do have the nucleus. So this archaea, they appears to be more common with the eukarya than the bacteria. So this archaea is what is happening, they differ from the bacteria in the cell wall composition, and it differs from the bacteria and the eukaryotes in the membrane composition and rRNA types. So this archaea, bacteria and the eukaryote are the 3 domain system. So this, I will explain you this archaea, bacteria and this eukaryote in detail in my next video. I hope you understood this content, and please watching this video, and I need your support to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.